Murphy went to the doctor. He says, "Doctor, it's awful, it's terrible." And the doctor says, "What's the problem?" And Murphy says, "No matter where I touch myself, here or here or here or here, it's excruciatingly painful. Just sheer agony." And the doctor examined him from head to foot. He said, "Murphy, I found your problem." He says, "What is it?" He said, "Your finger's broken." Murphy and O'Brien in a pub as usual. Murphy's feeling kind of down. O'Brien says, "What's the problem?" Murphy said, "I'm going on vacation to Spain next week and I don't know how I'll communicate. I don't speak the language." O'Brien said, "It's very easy. When you get to Spain, just speak slowly. They'll understand everything." So Murphy flies to Spain, checks into the hotel, goes down into the lounge bar, sitting at a table, and the waiter came over. Murphy said, "I'd like a beer, please." And the waiter went away and got it, brought it back. Murphy said, "Thank you." And the waiter said, "You're welcome. Where are you from?" Murphy said, "I'm from Ireland." And the waiter said, "Really? I'm from Ireland too." Murphy said, "Then why are we speaking Spanish?" You were getting ahead of me there, weren't you? Murphy and O'Brien out in the woods, they come to a clearing and they see an abandoned well. And Murphy said, "I wonder how deep that well is." O'Brien said, "There's one way we can figure it out." Murphy says, "What's that?" He said, "You drop something down it, you time how long it takes to hit the bottom, you multiply that by 32 feet per second squared, the rate at which objects fall in a vacuum, subtract a little for wind resistance, we've got the depth of the well." Murphy says, "What are you going to drop down it?" And O'Brien looked all around and he saw this big heavy log lying on the ground. He squats down beside the log and using his legs correctly, he gets it up onto his shoulders and he staggers over to the edge of the well, tips it up, drops the log down, and they start to count. 1 hippopotamus, 2 hippopotamus, 3 hippopotamus, splash. Murphy said, 3 seconds. O'Brien said, "Quick, multiply that by 32 feet per second squared. 288 feet. Subtract a little for wind resistance. Let's say 18 feet. The depth of that well is 270 feet. Just then Murphy shouts, "Look out!" And he pushed O'Brien backwards, and a goat ran between them and jumped head first down the well. Murphy says, "My God, I've never seen anything like that." Just then a farmer walks into the clearing. He said, "What's going on here, boys?" O'Brien says, "We just figured out the depth of this well. We figure it's about 270 feet deep, and the strangest thing happened. A goat ran between the two of us and jumped head first down the well." The farmer said, "Thank heavens it wasn't one of my goats." Murphy says, "How do you know it wasn't?" He said, "All my goats are tethered to big heavy logs." Murphy and O'Brien out in the woods deer hunting. They shoot a deer. They're dragging it back to their pickup truck, but they're pulling it by the back legs, so the antlers are getting caught in the bushes and the undergrowth, and it's taken them forever. The guy comes out from behind a tree. He said, "You know, boys, it's a lot easier if you pull that deer by the head. That way the antlers won't get caught in the bushes. It's a lot faster." So they start to pull the deer by the head. Sure enough, it's much easier. O'Brien turns to Murphy. He said, "That guy was right. This is a hell of a lot quicker." Murphy said, "Yeah, but we're getting farther away from the truck." Then they decided to go bear hunting. Came to a fork in the road, said bear left, so they went home. They decided to go ice fishing. Get out on the ice and they drill a hole, just about to drop their lines in and start fishing. And this disembodied voice rings out, "There are no fish beneath the ice." That scares them. So they move a bit further away. They drill another hole, just about to drop their lines in. They hear it again, "There are no fish beneath the ice." They're getting really scared now. Move even farther away, drill another hole, just about to start fishing once more, and they hear it again. "There are no fish beneath the ice." Murphy looks up, said, "Is that you, Lord?" And the voice said, "No, I'm the rink announcer." Yeah, then they decide to go fishing in a boat on a lake. They're out there, they feel a bump against the side of the boat, and they look over, and there's a bottle floating in the water. So they lift the bottle into the boat, and they pull the cork out. A genie pops out and said, "I can grant you one wish." O'Brien doesn't hesitate. Says, "One wish. I wish this whole lake was Guinness." The genie said, "You've got it, Shazam. The whole lake is Guinness." Murphy slaps O'Brien upside the head. He said, "You idiot." O'Brien says, "What?" Murphy says, "Now we have to pee in the boat."